Okay, so we are still missing a little bit of lines here because I couldn't see it through, but now I can see it very, very lightly. I actually can see a little bit of the eye. So we're not going to worry about this eye. We're not going to draw it right now. We're just going to shade it, and then we're going to put this eye the last moment after the shading. So the most important now, just kind of try to repeat this line, the line of the hair. So we're just kind of going to draw it now as we can see it on the photo a little bit, but remember it's going to be in a very, very dark shadow. It's all going to be in a dark area. So it's not really that important, but we are trying to be as accurate as possible. Kind of mark the eyes about here and the faces about here.
Okay, so mark the line of the face. It's all dark, but the background is a little bit darker than the face. So that's how we're going to distinguish between background and the face here. And we marked the window. So the see line of the neck is kind of slightly visible here. It's close to this line that we marked. So we kind of need to mark it here lightly. And it's all going to be in the dark. So again, so we're going to shade it all first. And the line of the shoulder is slightly visible here. And that's our window line. We just kind of have to measure. Remember the angling technique? We can measure this angle, put it here, compare, keep the same angle, and that's we can just check this. But you know, the background lines, they're not so important, they're a little bit distorted. Or the facial lines are more important, and we shouldn't distort them. Okay, the hair is going to develop that part of the ear, so that's where the hair is connected to the head. Okay, and now we can just start shading. A lot of dark shading is ahead of us, so it's going to be a long shading process. Well, I'm going to start with hatching marks. As you can see, I'm shading. This is a big reminder. Shading is done faster if you keep your pencil almost parallel to the surface of the paper. And we're not shading like that, okay? We're not leaving that wide gaps. We're trying to shade smoothly, so no gaps is left between the marks. And very lightly, as you can see. So to get it darker, we're going to go layer over layer over layer. So now where it's really dark, we see that here are very dark here. And the neck is dark, so we're just going to continue shading there. So we just shade continuously. Continuously. Till we come to the shoulder. And the shoulder, as we can see, is also dark, but it's lighter. If you squint, you'll see that shoulder is a little bit lighter than the background. Well, the background also gets a little bit lighter here. So it means here we need to do a lot more shading. I'm going to go with the hatching marks for a while before I switch to cross hatching. The highlights on the hair, it's not as light as the highlights on the skin. Notice that. So I'm just going to go over the hair as well. Shading everything. So if your drawing is that dark and you are impatient, you like to keep things moving faster, I would maybe recommend you using charcoal. With this drawing, with this particular photograph, the probably appropriate medium would be charcoal, and then you could use a subtractive method to get to the highlights. But it's up to you. You have to make a decision about what media to use in this drawing. Now guys, remember this is all dark part of the face. It's a terminator. Signifies dark part of the face. So I'm continuing shading here dark part of the face. But because it's darker, the background here darker, so not to lose completely right at the beginning of the face, I'm going to keep this line by darkening it even more beyond this line, beyond the line of the face. But I'm going to keep this line very, very fuzzy. Not very sharp. Now press a little bit more to get it darker. I like to make little marks where the darkest darks are going to be, and I notice that here is kind of one of the darkest dark. So I'm trying to keep all my shadows pretty much at the same level, evenly all across the drawing. I do want to like to mark some darkest darks so I don't lose my drawing. So I'm marking here a little bit darker so I didn't lose that shadow in the division between face and the hair. And here I need to make the hair a little bit darker than the background. So I'm darkening here a little bit. Now it's all done. Now I can keep shading more evenly. You can see that I do not draw the individual hair strands yet. This is going to be icing on the cake. I'm just darkening it over, and I still see my lines that I kind of put first when I was drawing the hair. But that's about it, and I'm still able to see the lines at this moment. So I don't lose my shoulder there. I'm darkening just slightly beyond that shoulder. if you look at this landscape of the face, I'm going to when I put this little bit of transitional shadow here on the face, I lost the darkness of the neck, which means I have to darken this neck a little bit more. So I don't lose that, but it just looks maybe that shadow a little bit too dark, but it's not too dark because we haven't darkened everything else. We need to start darkening everything else in that area that we marked as this is going to be our transitional light. And this is the highlight, so we have to avoid that area, but this is all kind of transitional light. This is not the highlight, this is the highlight. So we have to keep looking at the photograph so we remember which one was which. And this is the highlight area, pretty light. So we're going to keep it. Now this is not white light, so we're going to darken that. Now, important to keep looking at the photo, especially when there's some small areas, like in the ear. When you're shading, see how if I want to make a little bit more pronounced marks with my pencil, I keep my, like here when I don't want pronounced marks, I keep my pencil almost parallel to the paper. When I want pronounced marks, I put my paper a little bit more vertical to keep the kind of hatching marks a little bit more visible, so they will look more like here, so it's kind of more like cross contour marks. And they're not as much visible everywhere, so the here they're just dark, so we can just kind of start to dark shading again. And background here looks darker. That's how we're able to see highlights on the hair, because the background is so dark.